Hello, my Sparies. It's Keisha from Faith and Properties, and I just wanted to come back again for my day four of my 21 days of fasting. As I promised, I will be doing a series of each day, my vision or whatever happened that is in my mind or rests on my heart that I need to share with you guys. Day four, I didn't get a vision, unfortunately. I didn't dream anything, and also I didn't pray. I just fast that day, which is not so great, but I had something to do. I started my business, and there's this course that I should have been taking for my business, and I just hop into launching the business without taking the course. And so the Holy Spirit was speaking to me that I need to finish this course. So I kind of gave the first three days of my fasting. While I was on fasting, I was trying to just get through this course. So day four was the last day that I had on schedule to finish my course. So I did so on day four, and I kind of like reserved that day to just focus on completing this course. So that's what I did on that day. And also what I wanted to share with you guys, why do we fast? And I may be reading because I jot something down. You can see why do we fast. There's a lot of like videos about fasting, and if you do read your Bibles, there's a lot of stories as to why we should fast. And you know, when the disciple, like everyone, like almost everyone like on YouTube talk about the disciples trying to get rid of the demon in one of the young men in somewhere in Matthew. I will put the verse that you, if you want to read for yourself. And they couldn't get the demon out of this young man, and so they were asking God, how did he do it? And Jesus, how he did it. And Jesus told them that this kind of fast, this kind of demon does not come out by prayer only. It comes out through prayer and to praying and fasting. And everyone knows about the Easter fast, or most of you guys should know about the Easter fast. If you haven't, then I'll link the story that you can read for yourself in the Bible, so you can read it for yourself and understand the Easter fast. And also the Daniel fast, you can find it Daniel 10, and I also will put it there for you to see it. So it was a Daniel 21 day fast that I was doing. But let me just explain the true meaning behind the spiritual fast. So when you fast, we're giving up food, which give us energy. Through food, we have energy to do whatever that we want to do. We're energized, and we think, or basically giving our flesh energy to do things, to go about, to just enjoy life, and to just satisfy our flesh. But if we do fast food, what it does, it will allow the flesh to get weakened. And so when the flesh is weakened, it goes to sleep. The flesh goes to sleep, and our spirit man, our spirit inside of us, is able to connect with the Spirit of God or with any spirit. But we, in order for us to be prone to connect to any form of spirit, if we do not eat, so, and we lose our energy, so our flesh is weak and our spirit becomes alive. And if we choose as Christian to fast, to connect with the Spirit of God, so when we put our flesh to sleep, we're able to use our spirits. And in order to feed our spirit, we feed it through prayer, we should feed it through reading our Bible. And so when we do that, feed the Holy Spirit, it connect with God, and we're able to communicate with God. We hear more more clearer and we are able to get visions and see some of the deep dirty stuff that's in our past that we need to get rid of. Forgiveness. I am honestly struggling with forgiveness, and I've been praying like someone has done something to me. To a lot of people, it's unforgivable. I've been struggling with this forgiveness part of it, and even after my 21 days of fasting, I still feel like I'm struggling with it. And that's one of my prayer right now, is for God to help me to forgive, or to just purify my heart so that I can forgive this person. It's, you know, when you trust someone with your entire heart, your soul, every fiber, everything that makes you up, and that person basically ruined that trust, it makes it so hard to forgive. And that's where I'm at right now. I think I'm at a better place right now with that trust. I think I'm getting there. I think that forgiveness part is flowing. It's coming. I'm just praying that my heart become pure and totally forgive, so that it's behind me, and I pray that I will never pick it up, because it's the worst kind of thing. Because if we don't forgive, that you're not going to get your breakthrough. So far I haven't really experienced a breakthrough because I have that unforgivable part hanging on to. So not until I forgive, then that's when my breakthrough will come, and I can't wait to experience the breakthrough and what God has planned for me and planned for my life. So I just want to share that with you guys. Just keep watching, keep sharing my videos, and subscribe, and tell your families and friends to subscribe. There is more like of my my Daniel fast coming up, because we're only at the third day, I believe. No, the fourth day. So we're only at the fourth day, so we have a lot more days to come. So yes, so far the fourth day there was many dream. I didn't do much. I just fast, basically didn't eat, but I spent time doing my completing the course that I was supposed to do in regards to my business. And I'm happy that I did it, because that was a part of why I fast too, because I wanted to be able to complete it, and I wanted to be able to get on track with my business. So hope you guys have a great day, a great week, and a great month, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye.